I want to share a pro tip with you guys that I think is pretty cool, and it's creating a rolling calendar. So in the case that we just walked through, we loaded up a discrete set of dates because we only wanted to analyze the data that we had on hand. In our particular case, we won't need to change that calendar. We won't need to pull in new data or analyze new information over time. But what if you're in a situation where you do? You know, maybe you've built a weekly report that you want to refresh with new data every week and share with your colleagues or your boss or your client. Rather than creating a fixed calendar and updating it over time, what we're going to do is actually use a little bit of M code. And I know this is the last bit of M that we're going to touch, but trust me, it's worth it. We're going to use that M code to create a calendar that will update based on the current point in time. So it will act as a rolling calendar that evolves as time goes on. So I'm going to lay out the steps here, and then we're going to jump into Power BI, and I'll demo what that looks like. So step one, this is going to be a great time to test that blank query option that I showed you earlier. So we'll create a new blank query, and then in our formula bar, we're going to generate a starting date by entering something called a literal, and you're going to write it exactly like it's shown here, with a hash mark, the word date, and then a starting date, whatever you choose, in the year, month, date format. So in the example we're looking at here on the slide, this would represent January 1st, 2018. From there, you're gonna click the FX icon, which adds a new custom step, and you're gonna enter the following M formula. Now, I know it's a lot, and I'll post this function into the Q&A section as text so that you can copy and paste it, but we're not really gonna dig in and unpack how this formula is working. We're just going to use it almost like a recipe to create our list of dates. So once you've added that formula, a list will populate in the query editor, and then we're going to convert that list into a table, and then we'll format that column as a date. Last but not least, if you want to, you can add some more calculated date columns, just like we showed with our last example. You can add years, months, week, whatever you need using those add column options, but it's really as simple as that. So let's hop into Power BI. I'm going to write out this formula, and I'll show you exactly how it works. All right, so I'm back in my AdventureWorks report. This time I'm going to go into the Get Data option, but instead of choosing CSV, I'm going to pick that blank query option down at the bottom. This takes me straight into the query editor and creates a new query just called Query 1. And if we wanted to, we could give this a name like rolling_calendar. Don't worry too much about this because I will be deleting this query after I write it, but just for the sake of habit, you'd want to give that a proper table name. And then inside of the formula bar, this is where we're going to type that formula that I just reviewed. So first step was to use the literal equals pound sign or hash, date, open parenthesis, and then for the sake of example, let's use 2018, comma 1, comma 1, that will give us January 1st, 2018. And when we press enter, it just basically creates a single value, 1/1/2018. So that's not very helpful yet on its own, but it's a good starting point. The next step is to click this FX button to add a new step. And right here where it says equals source, this is where I'm going to type that long M formula that I shared with you. So follow along. I'm going to move kind of quickly, but go ahead and pause it once I enter the whole function so that you can make sure you've got it written down. So we're gonna start with list.dates, open a parenthesis, source, comma, number.from, open paren, date time, dot, local, now, quick open and close paren, just like the now or today function in Excel. We're going to close out one more parenthesis, minus number dot from, open paren, source, close paren, comma, pound sign, duration, open paren, 1, 0, 0, 0, and then 2 closed parentheses to end it. Now, without diving too deep into exactly what this M code is doing, in a nutshell, what we're saying is calculate the current date, compare that against the literal that we just created, which is our starting date, and then based on the difference between those two dates, I want you to list out all of the individual values where the duration is 1 day. So it's basically saying, give me a list at daily granularity between those dates, the literal and the current date based on today. So when we press enter, there we go. It created this whole list. And look at this. It starts at 1/1/2018. And as I scroll down through, it ends at 4/16, which is the current date. It's April 16th, 2018, as I'm recording this. And if we were to refresh this query a week from now, that end date would extend 7 more days. So we've essentially created this dynamic rolling list of dates. That was the hard part. Now all we need to do is click this new list tools tab that popped up. And we're just going to click this button on the left to table. And it basically converts it into a table. There's no delimiter. We shouldn't have any errors here, so we can just press OK. There we go. Final step is to format and name the column, and then we should be done. So go ahead and format as a date. Instead of column one, you'd call it something like date. And now we've got a single column date table, just like we started with in the last demo. And from here, we could go ahead and add as many of those calendar fields as we wanted to. So really great tip that I use a lot in my own work. I manage a ton of reports that have to be updated very frequently, and this rolling calendar is a huge time saver for working with reports like that. So for the purposes of this course and this demo with our AdventureWorks data, we actually don't need the rolling calendar. We're going to rely on our AW calendar lookup table instead. So I know we just did all that work. We could keep the calendar here if we wanted to, or in this case, I'm just going to right click and delete that query. Really just want to focus on the one calendar table that we've got for the sake of this analysis. But there you go. Let's close out of the query editor and we're back to square one. So that's your pro tip, how to create a rolling calendar.